Everyone, today we are going to deal with linear differential equation with variable coefficients. Here we have two methods for solving linear differential equation with variable coefficients. The first method is Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation and the second one is Legendre's homogeneous linear equation. Now we look into the how we have to solve the Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation. Consider a differential equation of the form x to the power n dny divided by dxn plus a1 x to the power n minus 1 dn minus 1 of y divided by dxn minus 1 so on up to an of y which is equal to x. Call it as equation number 1. Here a1, a2, so on up to an are called as constants and the RHS part that x is called as a function of x. The equation 1 is called as Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation. Now, how to solve the equation 1 by various substitution? That is, here we have to substitute x is equal to e to the power z, then z is equal to log x. When z is equal to log x, then dz by dx which is equal to 1 by x. Therefore, x dy by dx which is equal to capital D into y and x square d square y by dx square which is equal to d into d minus 1 of y, where capital D is equal to d divided by dz. Similarly, I can write the nth term, that is x to the power n dn of y divided by dx to the power n which is equal to d into d minus 1 so on up to d minus n minus 1th term of y. With all these above substitution in equation 1 will be reduced to the differential equation with constant coefficients which can be solved by the Cauchy's method. Now we look into the first example, that is x square d square y by dx square minus x dy by dx plus y which is equal to log x. Rewrite the equation as it is and call it as equation number 1. Here we have to substitute x is equal to e to the power z and z is equal to log x. Then x dy by dx will be written as dy. And x square d square y by dx square which will be written as d into d minus 1 of y. With all above substitution in equation 1, equation 1 will be written in the form of d into d minus 1 of y minus dy plus y which is equal to z. Simplify it, I am going to get d minus 1 whole square of y which is equal to z. Call it as equation number 2. For the equation 2, by the earlier method, that is auxiliary equation for the equation 2 can be written as m minus 1 whole square which is equal to 0. Therefore, what are the roots of m minus 1 whole square is equal to? That is 1 and 1. Here if we observe, the roots are real and equal. Therefore, the complementary function for the these roots can be written as c1 plus c2 z into e to the power z. Now I have to find the particular integral, that is RHS divided by the auxiliary equation. Here the RHS is z and auxiliary equation is m minus 1 whole square, that is d minus 1 whole square. When the denominator part shifted to the numerator, it becomes 1 minus d to the power minus 2 of z. The 1 minus d to the power minus 2 which can be expanded as 1 plus 2d plus 3d square plus so on up to z. Now simplify it, 1 into z is z and plus 2 into d. D means d by dz, therefore differentiation of z is 1, that is 2 into 1 which is equal to 2. The further 3d square, double differentiation of z is 0, therefore the further terms vanishes, only we remain with z plus 2. Now we are going to write the general solution. General solution is nothing but y is equal to cf plus pi, that is complementary function plus pi. The complementary function is c1 plus c2z into e to the power z and the pi is z plus 2. We are re-substituting back the value of z and e to the power z as we substituted above, that is e to the power z is equal to x and z is equal to log x in the cf and pi. Finally, we are going to write the complete solution. Now we look into the second example, that is x cube d cube y by dx cube plus 3x square d square y by dx square plus x dy by dx plus 8y which is equal to 65 cos log x. here also substitute, x is equal to e to the power z and z is equal to log x, and the first derivative x dy by dx is equal to capital D into y, and the second derivative x square into y double dash can be written as d into d minus 1 of y, and the third derivative, that is x cube into y triple dash, which can be written as d into d minus 1 d into d minus 2 of y. With all the substitution, the given equation becomes d into d minus 1 d minus 2 plus 3d of d minus 1 plus d plus 8 of y, which is equal to 65z. Simplify it, I am going to get d cube plus 8 of y, which is equal to 65z. The auxiliary equation of this will be m cube plus 8, which is equal to 0. Please resolve into that factors, that is m plus 2 bracket of m square minus 2m plus 4, which is equal to 0. When m plus 2 is equal to 0, then m is equal to minus 2. Then resolve into factors, that is by factorization method. Here I am going to apply the Schrader's formula, that is minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. When I apply this, I am going to get the answer as 1 plus or minus I root 3. Then the complementary function will be written as c1 plus e to the power minus 2t, then this is imaginary, therefore plus e to the power t bracket c2 cos root 3z plus c3 sin root 3z. Now I am going to find the particular integral, that is yp is equal to 65 cos z divided by dq plus 8. This is of type 2, that is sin a or cos ax. Here in this method we are going to substitute d square is equal to minus a square, therefore the coefficient of z is 1 here, therefore we are writing, that is d square is equal to minus is out, then 1 square, it will be minus 1. Here d cube is there, therefore I'll take 1 d out, then d square plus 8, then d as it is, this d square, that minus 1 plus 8, which is equal to 65 cos z divided by minus d plus 8. Please take the conjugate of that, then 8 plus d divided by 8 plus d, because we have to eliminate this d. 65 8 plus d cos z divided by 8 is 64 plus into minus minus d square. Now simplify it, 65 8 cos z is equal to 8 cos z plus differentiation of cos z, d means differentiation, therefore differentiation of cos z is minus sin z divided by 64 minus, again coefficient of z is 1, minus 1 whole square, that is minus 1, minus into minus is plus, 65 and 65 will get cancelled, we remain with only 8 cos z minus sin z. Therefore the general solution will be written as y is equal to yc plus yp, that is your complete solution. Now we look into the third example, that is x square d square y by dx square minus 3x dy by dx plus 4y, which is equal to 1 plus x whole square. Here also write or substitute x is equal to e to the power z, then z is equal to log x. X dy by dx can be written as dy, and x square d square y by can be written as d into d minus 1 of y. With all above substitution in given equation, the given equation after simplifying, it becomes d square minus 4d plus 4 of y, which is equal to, this is in the form of a plus b the whole square, therefore a square plus b square plus 2ab. Please write the expansion of that, then d minus 2 the whole square of y, which is equal to 1 plus 2e to the power z plus e to the power 2z. The auxiliary equation of these equation, I mean the above equation, becomes m minus 2 whole square, which is equal to 0. Then if I find the roots, then I'll get m is equal to 2 and 2. Here the roots are real and equal, therefore the complementary function will be written as c1 plus c2z into e to the power 2z. Now we'll find the particular integral, that is 1 divided by the auxiliary equation plus second term divided by auxiliary equation plus third term divided by auxiliary equation. Here if you observe, it is of type 1, therefore d is substituted by e. Here the exponential term is not there, therefore I am writing it as e to the power 0 into z. E to the power 0 is nothing but 1, therefore 1 into 1 is again a 1. therefore the coefficient of z is 0, then it will become 0 minus 2 whole square, therefore 1 by 4 plus 2 into e to the power z, then here 1 minus 2 the whole square, that is 1 minus 2 the whole square plus, here if I substitute 2 here, 2 minus 2 the whole square is 0, therefore I am fine, when f dash of a is 0, then I have to find f dash of a. If f dash of a again 0, then I am finding f double dash of a, then finally I am writing the answer. Therefore, that is y is equal to complementary function plus pi. You have to write the complete solution from the above answer, that whatever the complementary solution you are getting, that and plus the PI, that gives your complete solution. Now we look into the last example, that is x t cube y by dx cube plus d square y by dx square, which is equal to 1 by x. Here this is not in the standard form, therefore I am multiplying it by the above equation by x square. If I multiply by x square, then I'll get x cube y triple dash plus x square y double dash, which is equal to x. Again here substituting e to the power z is equal to x, then z is equal to log x. Then the first derivative, that is x into y dash, can be written as d into y, and x square y double dash can be written as d into d minus 1 of y, and x cube y triple dash can be written as d into d minus 1 d minus 2 of y. Substituting all this in the this equation becomes d into d minus 1 d minus 2 plus d into d minus 1 of y, which is equal to e to the power t or e to the power z. Please simplify it. I am going to get m into m minus 1 of m minus 2 plus 1 of, that is equal to 0. I am going to get, after simplifying, m of m minus 1 whole square, which is equal to 0. Then I am going to get 3 roots, that is m is equal to 0, comma 1, comma 1. These two are real and equal, and this is the different root. Therefore, the complementary function will be c1 plus c2 plus c3z into e to the power z. Now we'll find the particular integral, that is RHS divided by the auxiliary equation e to the power z divided by d cube minus 2d square plus d. This is of type 1, therefore d is replaced by a. The what coefficient of z is 1, therefore 1 is replaced in all the d, that is 1 minus 2 into d square is 1 plus 1. Here the denominator is going to be 0, therefore I am finding f dash of a. When I found the f dash of a, again it is going to be 0, then I am finding f double dash of a, then I am going to get z square into e to the power z divided by 6d minus 4, z square e to the power z, the coefficient of z is 1, 6 into 1 is 6 minus 4, which is equal to 2. Now we are writing the complete solution, that is y is equal to yc plus yp, that is your yc is c1 plus c2 plus c3z of e to the power z, then yp is z square e to the power z divided by 2. Replace e to the power z as x and z is equal to log x, you are going to get the complete solution, that is y is equal to yc plus yp. Thank you.